is up, Yesh Gamers? Robert the Bruce here, back again with an episode of Riding Shotgun. Now today we're going to be playing some Conquest Large. Last time we did Team Deathmatch, showing you some of my strategies there. Again, if this is your first episode of this series that you're seeing, basically it's just you come along with me, and I'm giving some play-by-play tactics of what I'm actually thinking while I go. It's not a nicely edited together video of all my best moments or anything. It's just the nitty-gritty, good and bad, all in one look at like what I'm thinking the whole time that I'm playing. So today we're gonna play some Conquest Large. I just hopped in this random server, totally solo, don't have a squad with me. So this is unfortunately where a lot of guys find themselves in Battlefield, is alone. They don't have a squad they run with a lot, so they're running solo. And so that is how I'm gonna play this one. And it looks like there are some baddies hiding out here at Echo. No, I'm gonna go. Ah, somebody took the boat. I was about to get it and then go rock the high seas. Alright, so let's jihad those tanks back there. That's gonna be our starting out strategy. Take out some of the armor that is probably crippling us. I thought that was a good guy about to steal his Jeep. I was like, bro, you don't want it. Trust me. This was ill-conceived plan. Oh! An epic fail of the jihad. That guy's a terrible shot. How am I alive? How am I alive? And now he's chasing me. His friend had to kill me. All right, so you just saw an epic fail jihad attempt, but that's okay, I'm gonna leave it in. Just for the laughs. And that first tank guy should be ashamed of himself. Okay, now we're getting corralled here. They have a boat out guarding Charlie. It's gonna be really tough to take that. And Delta and Echo is where all the fighting is gonna be. This is a little risky, but again, we're talking solo strategy. What can I do to help the team the most? What can I do all by myself that can try to swing the tides of this war? So I'm gonna try something a little risky here and see if I can run this boat all the way to Alpha. Keeping an eye, now they got a tank back there just lobbing shells. That's not out of the ordinary. Pretty campy way to play it, but people like to do that because they think that somehow their KD matters. Now hopefully he doesn't see me and set his sights on me. We're gonna come flying up here and hopefully, stuck on the curb. I hate when that happens. Like a 6-inch curb blocks you from moving forward. Now we wanna, we wanna go ahead and get a beacon down ASAP and then actually move away from it so that that is a bad guy for sure. Where was he? Oh, he's up there. You should be ashamed of yourself, sir. Did you have a friend in here? No, he's on the roof, I think. Maybe my guy. Can't remember what language he yelled out. Yep, guess that was my guy. So yeah, pay attention to that. That's the first little tip of the day. The languages that you hear. You quickly see I'm on the Chinese team. We're playing against the Russians. You can pick out Chinese and Russian. Don't sound anything alike. So listen for the voices you hear. You know, you kill a bad guy, and then you suddenly hear something that sounds like Russian. Well, that's a bad guy. And he's saying that his teammate just died. And that gives you a really good clue about who else is in the area. Let's go here. Heyo. Oh gosh, those guys are way too far away for this ACR. Man. Now they're chasing me, I think. Turn off the laser sight. Yep. Surprise. Now the other guys. That was a one and done. If I get too cute with it. Oh my gosh, you gotta be kidding me. My guy must have put on some weight because that was a pretty wide opening and he couldn't run through it. Turn off the laser sight when you know guys are looking your direction. It's just a dead giveaway of, hey, here I am. So That worked out well. Now, this guy still thinks I'm down there. We may even get some tags if I get greedy. Nope! Almost lost it. Almost lost it completely out of my greed for the tags. That's okay. I'm always okay with dying because I was going for tags. We got random stuff out there. I don't see any tanks lit up. Now, we've actually taken over this map pretty darn well, which is awesome. I'm thinking a Jeep is in order. I'm actually going to roll a Jeep back to Alpha, because if we can keep them stuck at Delta... Sorry, dude, I don't know if you were wanting a ride. He didn't yell it out, so I'm assuming no. Epic jump! Oh, almost did a barrel roll. Almost did it again. Okay, we got Alpha, so that was all for nothing, but that's okay. That's sometimes how conquest... Oh, look at that sweet emblem on the side of that Jeep. Oh, yeah. That's how it goes with conquest. You know, you travel across the map only to find out that your teammates actually already took care of it. Ooh, although, you know what? This guy needs to be taken care of. Hopefully that wasn't somebody just taking care of him. Yeah, there he is. Surely they don't have mines in their own base. Oh, I'm gonna die before... Oh no, there he is! All or nothing! I hadn't stopped. That's one of my favorite things to do, is to actually suicide in the no man's land, but get a jihad kill in there. Because guys, I mean, that guy, he's camped as far back as he can get. He thinks he's safe. So I love killing those guys. I don't know why. I think it's fun. Anyway, this guy is... Oh, that is hysterical. Look at that. He just drove up and dropped C4 on that. And now he's backing away and he's gonna dead. Green Ma 1997 in the kill feed. Dude, bravo. That was great. Okay, let's get to Charlie. We don't want to lose this one. Charlie is a clutch point. It's hard to cap back. We're going to get a beacon down. It looks like the only thing they've got is a chopper, so I'm screwed because I don't have anything to touch that. Except this tree! I may need to come back in with an RPG or something. Yeah, we're going to do that. We're going to come back with an RPG. Before, or let's do a small. Put it on the highlight reel. That guy could not have been very pleased when he saw the replay. That was like Babe Ruth style. I called it. So yeah, Charlie on this map is a clutch point. You lose Charlie, and it's tough to gain back. So you don't want to... Oh boy, they got something that's going to tear me up over there. Run, boat, run! He's trying to chase me down, too. That's okay, I need to go to Alpha anyway, because we're losing it. So I'm going to slide over here. Live to fight another day. Oh, nice parallel parking with the rib boat. All right, now where are the baddies? I don't have my beacon, unfortunately, so... I don't even know what gun I have. Is this AK-5, it looks like? That guy has my number. Go get him, dude! He's right in that building! Oh, all he did was die. I gotta get out of this area. He's got my number. Swing around to the other side. Maybe he'll think I'm just running away. At least he won't be able to see me. Hop out and come in here. Surprise! Kind of surprised that worked, actually. Oh, gosh, I heard footsteps up there, and I didn't stop to look at my mini-map. I thought surely that was a bad guy. He's probably making fun of me right now, and I'm okay with it. All right. Ah, we're losing Charlie again. Do we have any... Really? A tree took care of me?
Man.
Don't have any, Maybe he's gonna come cap this one now, that'd be nice. I thought that was money. Let's go for a crazy one. Nope, he's moving too much. We're not gonna waste our time trying to get that. As tempting and fun as those are, it's not helping the team. All right, there's a riboat. Let's get back to Charlie. We need that one. Now, sadly, I'm not on Recon, which is one of my favorite classes, honestly, for except for a couple of maps. It's almost always my favorite class to run because of the spawn beacon. The spawn beacon is so clutch for getting your team. That guy gave away his position. Now I'm listening for, oh boy, somebody's lighting me up. It looks like a vehicle of some sort. I'm listening for enemy voices. As I'm, running through this map now. Ah! I knew I was gonna die there as well. So like I said earlier, you know, listening for those voices gives away their position really easily. Now, the way I knew I was about to die was because I was standing right next to the flag and it was not moving. So I'm the only one on the mountain, or on the island. Mountain. So I knew that there had to be another bad guy right in that vicinity. And since I was killing all of his teammates, he probably had me zeroed in, which he did. Alright guys, this episode ended up being pretty long, so I'm going to break it up into two parts. First one uploaded now, obviously. The second one will upload tomorrow, so we'll be looking for part two of this episode of Riding Shotgun. Thanks for tuning in.
If you haven't yet, treat yourself and click that subscribe button. Click the question mark below it to be taken to a totally random video of mine. No guarantees which one you will get. Lastly, if you're on Twitter, follow @YeshGaming because it is my favorite way to communicate with you.